Japan. Wow, we've been all over the place the last few weeks. We were getting things ready for the fair, baking breads, making plans, pulling out antiques, did a lot of seasoning of the cast iron. I had showed a few pieces of the cast iron at the fair. Had a ball. Haven't stopped cooking. I've been making fish and I made some meatballs. I can't remember, but we've been eating really, really, really well. This weekend I was out over at Junk Monkeys. I was at the Junk Fest. I was at the flea market just all over town, and I had some cornbreads with me, and passing out some samples of cornbread to folks. And I get a lot of pleasure out of that. People offer to pay me for it, and that's not what it's all about. I'd rather see the people enjoy the breads and things. So we're gonna keep doing that, and I'll be back out. I've taken a couple days off from baking. I'll be back after it. I'll put together a poolish tonight, or a couple of different poolishes tonight, and we'll be back at the baking thing. But anyway, today we're back. Mentioned the cast iron season. I have my big number 12 out here. I hadn't been used in a while. It's time to get that baby in the oven. And I have a little one here. Go figure. There's a reason for the, go figure. I have a piece of foil in the bottom of the cast iron skillet. So we're going to get this. We got these big giant split breasts. They look like they came off of turkeys. They're big giant pieces of meat here. We're just going to season those up and get them in the pan. And as always, I want to try to, I didn't mean to touch that before I picked up my spices. But anyway, I'm going to try to do a little of the experiment or figure something out while we're doing this. I'm a little bit concerned, and I do not want to dry out these chicken breasts. I want chicken breasts that I can carve on. I don't know what I want to do, but I don't want them to be dried out pieces of meat. What I'm going to do different on at least one of these, I'm going to season it heavily, just like the rest of them, and I'm going to wrap it in a parchment paper. And the idea is that I just want that to seal that moisture in. I think we're going to get somewhere on this parchment paper. Yummy. And that parchment paper does things. So that's what we're going to try to do today. So let me stop talking and get to seasoning. Okay, we're going to do this one first. We're leaving all of the skin on. I'm just going to leave that on. We're going to let that, we'll sort that out in the wash there. So this one's just going to have kosher salt. And it's going to leak into the pan. I don't care. This one you will just set down in that pan there. Just want to have some liquid in the pan. Yummy, yummy, yummy. I'm looking forward to this. Really looking forward to putting together this, or being back and visiting with you folks. It was the summertime. Summertime, we got summertime things to do, and I got a vacation planned coming up with my three wonderful daughters here. We're gonna make a trip to Vegas. I don't know why I put all of that on there. All right, look at that. That's a bunch of seasoning. This is my go-to garlic and herb, Kinder's garlic and herb. Got the things I want, unless I want something else or something special. This works for me for a lot of things. Oh yeah, I did need that big number 12. Look at the size of those chicken breasts. Huge. You know what? I'm gonna roll that top a little bit in there too. And let me do that. Roll that top in that oil at the bottom also in the oil. And put it on the parchment paper. Cut out two pieces. think just like that. I'm just going to set that baby in there like that, so we have the same thing sitting side by side. Alrighty, we'll get this baby baked. I'm going to do about 400 degrees, about 45, I think about closer to an hour with these, with the size of these chicken breasts. But we'll see, I'll monitor that, and we'll jump back in. And I'm glad this one's got a helper handle with it. Wow. So let's check this again. I checked that one and it was plenty good. This is all the way in. It's 173, 172, 173. So 172, 173, plenty done. 180 on that one. And I already checked this one a little bit ago. This is 198, 202. I don't know why that one's on fire there, but that's pretty good. All right. So let's see what we have here with the parchment paper. After all, that's what we were after to see. We know we got nice and crispy here. Oh. Really nice. Right, look at it. It's juicy. All of that. Just look at that juice running down all down and through there. That's pretty cool. That's what we were after. We'll be able to tell a little bit more later when I slice into it. But yeah, juice is running out into the bottom of the pan. It's sizzling down there. Alrighty. Super. We'll let that rest a little bit. We may come back, or we're going to come back and do some slicing, see what we have inside. Alrighty, let's cut into one of these and see what we have. That one is facing you, so let's see if we can. Make a couple cuts there. That's, wow. That's juicy in itself right there. It's nice and tender. Done through and through. Alrighty. Let's leave that there for right now. Let's take this other one that we cooked in the parchment paper and take a few slices off of that. Ooh, that's soft. That's soft like a... Alright. Let's see. What do you think? Can you tell the difference? I'm telling over here. I'm hoping I'm not leaning the plate, but I'm looking at all this juice down here. I believe these are juicier. Anyway, I'll take a little taste, and that's wonderful. That is really like a different animal. Like a different animal, like a different type of meat. Let's taste this one. It's off the side also. That's a really, 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 really good piece of chicken. But it doesn't compare to this. This one is really, really, really juicy. This one really juicy, but great chicken. I'm going to start trying to cook some more in that parchment paper. Anyway, folks, got to get out of here.
You say success. Glad to be back. The fall has started. It's 1st of October. Time to do some fall recipes. Pumpkin spice bread. Yummy. Yummy. Yummy.
Zoom in here. This is the one that was unwrapped, or one of the ones that was unwrapped. So you can see the skin browned up real well. But close look at what we have down in there. Here's the other one. This one, the skin, it was in the paper, but that's the side that was down on the bottom of the cast iron skillet. And I kind of tore that one apart a little bit, but it was that tender that it kind of fell apart like that.